Hello and welcome back to CloudWoods.net. My name is Mauricio and today we're talking about Dropbox. Dropbox is among the most well-known names in cloud storage, and for a good reason. It was founded all the way back in 2007, making it a veteran of the industry. Naturally, this means that there are high expectations, so let's dig in and see if it lives up to them. Before we do that, however, I'd just like to remind you to hit subscribe, obviously, and the like button and click on the bell. So obviously you can always see when we publish new videos here on YouTube. Dropbox, like many others, uses a freemium model. This means that you can actually get the service for free, but you're only going to have 2 gigabytes of storage space. This gives potential users a great opportunity to try the service, but anyone doing much serious work will actually need to upgrade. When it comes to that, there are 2 plans on offer, which aren't the cheapest out there. The lower plan, Dropbox Plus, gives you an impressive 2 terabytes of storage, while the Dropbox Professional plan allows you to store up to 3 terabytes. For a better deal, we suggest you look at sync.com by clicking in the card here. Moving from a weakness to a strength, let's talk about speed. Dropbox is remarkably fast thanks to its powerful servers as well as a sophisticated and highly optimized system by which the files are actually updated. Dropbox does not re-upload entire files when it syncs things, but instead only updates the parts of a file that has changed in reality, which can save huge amounts of time and obviously bandwidth. One interesting aspect of Dropbox is that it offers Google Drive integration, which is very rare in a cloud storage industry that mostly sees Drive as a direct competitor. Dropbox is also integrated with Microsoft Office, meaning you can create new documents or open existing ones right from the Dropbox website in either software you like, and anyone you're collaborating with can do the same. Collaboration is one area where Dropbox has improved greatly in recent years, but ultimately it's still more of a file syncing service first and a cloud collaboration platform second. Most of its features and functionality are geared towards giving you control over your files, things like in-depth versioning and rewinding, rather than being focused on letting others also work on and in your files. Dropbox seems to focus on the actual storage side of the business while letting integration with other third parties pick up the slack in other areas. Dropbox is now integrated with Trello and Zoom, for example, allowing you to post files to those services right from your Dropbox. While all of this integration has in some ways filled in the gaps where Dropbox was weak with things like collaboration, it has opened a completely different can of worms. Dropbox has poor security and privacy, largely as a prerequisite for being able to properly integrate with so many different services. It does not offer zero-knowledge encryption, for example, because it would be impossible to share files across multiple services and computers if the files were encrypted and only you had the key. If security and privacy is what you really care about, then check out Sync as a good alternative. If you're looking for secure cloud storage for your business and you need your files hosted in Europe, Treasure It is probably a good bet for you too. On top of this, Dropbox seems to not really care about user privacy at all. In its privacy policy, it outright says that it can access your data and look at it to ensure that you are not violating its policies. This is something most people would agree is a violation of privacy and will ultimately drive many people, including us, away from the service. If you're still interested in trying Dropbox out despite the, well, questionable security, I'll include a link down in the description box below so you can sign up for a free trial and get started right away. I'll also include a link to our full written review of Dropbox that goes into much more detail than what we discussed in this video. As always, thank you very much for watching, and remember to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming reviews. See you soon.